Well, so what is Budmo? Well, I'm sure by now all of you are aware that Budmo are the online expert when it comes to spare parts. And the best point is that they have the spare parts for all vehicles available in India. So even if your car is out of production now, maybe you have a last generation model, even then they have the spare part available. They have the entire catalog. And the best point is that they have the same spare part from a host of different component makers, which gives you great flexibility in the pricing overall. So check them out today. Check out the app. It's available both for iOS as well as Android devices. And also check out the website for the latest schemes as well as offers. Budmo.com, the expert of online spare parts.
Hi guys, welcome to Auto Portal, and today we will be giving a detailed overview of this new generation, newly developed Skoda Slavia. See, we can really call this a second generation Skoda Rapid, but just because Skoda Rapid has been removed from the production now, so this is a new generation car now with the latest technology, latest safety features, new power terrains, new transmission options, new safety features and whatnot. So let's just start this overview, and just in case you forgot to subscribe to the channel, get it considered, because you guys are really missing so many auto updates from us. Guys, you already know that Skoda has already planned India 2.0 project for us, and Volkswagen Skoda Group has actually invested 8,000 crore rupees as of now, and the projections are really nice, the outcomes are really nice. See the Slavia and you will be watching this sedan getting compete with Honda City and Maruti Suzuki's Ciaz along with Hyundai Verna now. So let's just come to the front profile of this car, and I will be taking you to the headlight of this car. So the headlight technology is really cool, and you will be looking to the LED DRL. This L-shaped LED DRL is really suiting this headlight unit, and the projector headlamp over here is blacked out, which will be playing the role of both high beam as well as a low beam. Skoda Crystal Lighting and embossing of Skoda Crystal Lighting is actually putting an impact on this headlight. Along with it, if I just take you to the turn indicator section, that is a bulb. If I just take you to the rear profile of this bumper, you will be looking of this circular fog lamp, and this is a halogen unit, sadly, along with a chrome lining which goes all across the fog lamp unit. Okay, let's just take you to the butterfly shaped signature styled Skoda grille here, and this chrome is really looking very nice. The grille is having enough space for the air dam, so the heat gets convected very easily. You can even see that the radiator and the condenser unit are quite good, and they are visible from here onwards, which means that heat can actually be convected through it when the car actually crosses the air. You'll be watching these mesh, which will be playing the role of air dam again. If I take you to the upper profile of this bonnet, and you will be seeing these creases which look very good and phenomenal to the body lines. Guys, this car has actually got 4541 millimeter of length, 1752 millimeter of width, and 1487 millimeter of height. That means this is now the most widest car in the segment right now, along with the longest wheelbase, that is 2651 millimeter. Guys, the tire section is really pretty enough to tackle with the day-to-day life of an individual, as it has got 205 55 radial 16 inches tires, which has been wrapped around an alloy wheel, which is a dual cut, machined cut and a precision cut alloy. If I take you to the fender, you will see a Skoda badging here, which is chromed enough and blacked out in the inner part of the design. So these are the dual tone treatment ORVM with turn indicators intact inside it. If you see that the chrome lining has went so far till the rear and gets a curve over here. The top profile actually gets a very neat and clean with a sunroof. The handlebars are actually designed with the request button along with the body colored and partially chromed. So guys, if I take you to the tail light section of this car, you will see that it is a splittable tail light, and the standard variant of this car gets a LED tail light unit, although the rear light and the turn indicator are the regular bulb. The panel gaps are consistent enough, and these proves that it is a German build and a Skoda, obviously. You will see a great badging of Skoda along with a Slavia written right and left of the trunk gate. While taking you towards the rear profile of this car, you will see that it gets a dual tone bumper too, with a reflector unit and a chrome line going all across its body. All right guys, let's just move to the boot of this sedan and you will see that it gets a deep trunk which actually facilitates 521 liter of a boot, which is sufficient enough. It is one of the largest boot in this segment. While comparing it with the Honda City itself gets a 507 liter of boot space, and this remains the largest one. Let me just take you to the interior of this car, and while you notice the steering wheel, you'll be noticing that this steering wheel has been shared with the Skoda Kushaq already. Yeah. See, this is the same unit. It is a two-spoke steering wheel with some controls on the right end that totally belongs to the service intervals and different modes which you can actually change through it. So guys, this is the digital instrument cluster of Skoda's Klaviyo with a speedometer in the middle. Although I can really change these modes by just clicking on the steering wheel controls which have been mentioned on the right section of the steering wheel. In the middle, you can see that the cluster has actually shifted itself to the analog speedometer. Again, if I click the button, you will see that the instrument cluster has been changed to the tachometer. You can also see the dashboard symbols floating all across the lower profile of the instrument cluster. Alright guys, this is the 10 inches touchscreen infotainment system, and you have already seen this touchscreen infotainment system in Skoda Kushaq. This gets the same touch response, even the same features have been mentioned. For example, an Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, phone connect. This is such a feature where you can actually connect your device using a Bluetooth connectivity. This touchscreen infotainment system also comes with connected features where you can actually connect it using the application called My Skoda Connect. You can access with different features, such as you can locate your car while you have parked at an unknown location. You can see your demographics, how you have driven the car prior and how you can actually drive it to get more fuel efficiency, better performance. So the connected features are something which are in trend right now because everyone wants to be smart, and these features actually not only make you smart but also make your life very easy and very convenient. This is the automatic climate control, which has a feather touch response with different modes mentioned here. This is the same unit which has been carried forward from Kushaq. Kushaq already gets this kind of automatic climate control. You also get 2C type USB ports along with a wireless charger. The two sides of the gear lever has been placed with ventilated seats left and right, along with idle start stop and lock unlock button. If you see that the interiors have been designed in such a way that a golden finish goes all across the body, and this looks so premium because it also carries an ambient lighting across it. So when the light turns off and you drive it in the night, this glows up and this totally changes the look of the interiors. Let me just take you to the glove box section, and here you will see that there is a cooled glove box as well as a card holder mentioned here. This glove box is having a pretty decent volume. You can actually put multiple things here without giving a second thought. There is an IRVM unit which is seamless, and it is an automatic IRVM which has been placed in the new Slavia. The reading lamps gets LEDs not only in the front but also in the rear profile. There is a sunroof also which you can actually operate through a single click and can be closed further in a single click. You will see that the Slavia has been offered with a leatherette touch seats, and these are the dual tone treatment seats which look pretty nice and goes with the interiors of the car. Since the interiors of the car are dual tone treatmented, and in this way these seats get so premium and look so phenomenal. Alright guys, it's time to take you to the rear seats of the car. You will see that a huge space has been created, and now this car gives complex to Honda City because it is already famous for its rear row comfort. So while watching at the seats, you will see that it has also got dual tone treatment, and the recline as well as under thigh support is so great and so amazing that once you sit on these seats, you will feel so cozy and so comfortable that a long journey where you have already covered 200 and 300 kilometers will go very comfortably. There are AC vents too, which doesn't get any volume control, but yes, they do are offered with two C-type USB slots which have been mentioned in the bottom profile of AC. So there is a pocket again a pocket inside a pocket where you can actually put your mobile very safely. You also get adjustable head restraints, which are 3 in number. You will also see a center armrest with 2 cup holders. Alright guys, let's just talk about the power terrains. The power terrain has been upgraded now. It now gets a 1.5 liter petrol 4 cylinder turbocharged engine and a 1.0 liter petrol 3 cylinder turbocharged engine. Although the 4 cylinder turbocharged engine, which is a 1.5 liter engine, now produces whooping 150 PS of power with 250 Newton meter of torque. Along with it, if I talk about 1.0 liter petrol turbocharged engine, it produces 115 PS of power and claims 175 Newton meter of torque. If we talk about the turbocharger of 1.5 liter, it is a variable vane geometry, which not only gives a great bandwidth to this car, but also increases the fuel efficiency. Also, the active cylinder technology not only switch offs the 2 cylinder while there is no load on the cylinder, like if you really want to go economic, you can rev less and that will actually cut 2 cylinders, making it more fuel efficient. So guys, this was all for today. I just hope you get all the possible information from my end. If so, please do hit the like button, subscribe to the channel for more updates. Until for the next time, bye bye, take care and consider Auto Portal subscribing.